They say I have a lazy tumor, so it doesn't grow as quick. So I'm like, eh, all right, I'll take it. You got to have a tumor. I guess it's better if it's lazy.
When I was diagnosed, the small community that I live in Tangier, where I'm from, everybody came together and raised money, had a banquet. Tangier had a what is it, a relay?
They had a little relay race.
Yeah, they had
too.
A little relay, and just seeing people care about you, you know, you don't realize that, you know, you might mean as much to people as you do, and it's very humbling. It's very, very humbling, for sure.
I've had brain cancer since 2008. Around November is when I started having headaches. I was seeing double vision, dragging my leg. When I'd write, it would go up, and I couldn't, like, keep it straight.
And you remember our first oncology visit kind of laid it out on the line that it's not much hope.
A doctor said, you will eventually die. I mean, imagine hearing a doctor say that. You just figure, wow, you know, I'm never going to be able to do anything, have children or anything. And we eventually went to a different doctor, one that was much more positive.
Then they referred us up here to Dr. Weingart, and been coming up here for surgery ever since.
Courtney has a primary brain tumor, and she's having at least her third surgery for this problem. And I've known her for more than 10 years, actually. So she's actually done really well, and she continues to do great because of this unique mutation in her tumor. And so then suddenly that changed everything.
So we discovered she had this mutation in her tumor called BRAF. It kept growing back in the same place near the surface of the brain. It didn't infiltrate into the brain as much as we normally expect for glioblastoma to do.
Very few of these kind of tumors have that mutation. So it's always been very focal, very localized, almost pushing the brain away from it, which makes removal of it much more effective in terms of getting local control for her.
So we started treatment with targeted therapy, and the name of those medicines are dabrafenib and trametinib, and she did well on them. Her tumor shrank away over the course of several years, and she remained on those therapies for several years and is now out more than 5 years later and continuing to do very well.
It's very, very tough to hear you've got cancer. My 23-year-old head couldn't process it, but it was almost like my point of view changed from why to, well, you know.
Thank you, or more.
Yeah, I'm still here after these many years, and, you know, I have so much to be thankful for if I were to die tomorrow.
Courtney is an incredibly optimistic and bubbly person. I think that really shows. And I think, you know, most of all, she has people and things she loves. Her garden, her chickens, her son, her husband, her parents. And that really shows through in her joy for living and joy for life.
Cash's a miracle. He really is. We had him in 2013. He was born, and he's the light of my life because I never thought I'd have him, you know? So he's everything. Where are you? Cash Ward, come here. We're talking about how much we love you. So basically, I live for him, you know? I'm looking forward to just watching Cash grow up, and he's my future, I feel like, you know? And that's all that really I care about.